live, helping Microsoft partners on their projects. And since 1.5 year now, I'm a partner service account manager with within Office 365 syndication program. And today I'm happy to present to you the two troubleshooting tools that should be able to help you with troubleshooting Office 365 issues. And the tools that I would like to present are the Microsoft Remote Connectivity Analyzer and the Mozdal Support Toolkit. So I will explain both tools and show you in a short demo how you can use these tools to troubleshoot some of the top support call drivers we see in Microsoft Office 365. So with that, I would like to start with the Microsoft Remote Connectivity Analyzer. So the Microsoft Remote Connectivity Analyzer is a web-based tool, and it can be used to troubleshoot connectivity issues that affects all kind of services. If we look at the tool later on in the demo, you will see that we can troubleshoot connectivity issues with the Exchange server on-premise, with Link server on-premise, but for us, the most interesting part would be Office 365 connectivity. So the tool will help any administrator to deploy Office 365 correctly so that all of their customers and clients are able to connect to the service correctly. So what the tool does, it will simulate several client logons, and it will also simulate mail flow scenarios. The tests are done from the Microsoft data center. And if we see that a test fail, we show a lot of troubleshooting tips that assist you to correct the problem. So we will go through the connectivity analyzer in more detail in the demo, and we'll show you exactly what we can do with it and show some of the issues that we see and how you can are able to look at it. So the tool is available on the web. It's the web link is testexchangeconnectivity.com, or you can also find parts of it in the Microsoft online portal. So we were able to integrate these tests also in the Microsoft online portal, so that it's easier for any administrator to get to the tools and maybe even before opening a ticket to Microsoft, look at this and maybe it can even solve your problem and you don't need to open a ticket to Microsoft. So when should I use it? There are different scenarios where you can use the tool. So the main point is connectivity. So Outlook connectivity, mobile connectivity, anything you can think of, connect to the Microsoft services. So DNS. So if we think about Office 365, there are several DNS entries that I need to enter for being able to use the service correctly. And with this tool, we are able to check if these entries are correctly set. Mobile devices, active sync. So am I able to connect correctly to the service with my mobile device? Free and busy. So check the free and busy between maybe a hybrid environment of Exchange. So Exchange on-premise connected with Exchange online in a hybrid deployment. Mailbox access. So am I able to connect to my mailbox correctly? Maybe mail migration. Am I trying to migrate from an existing mail solution to Office 365? Mail flow. So is mail flowing correctly to and from Office 365? And last but not least, single sign-on. So if I deployed a single sign-on solution with Office 365, I'm able to run some tests to make sure that everything is correctly set up. So here in more details, the exact tests that are available. I will not go through all of them. We will see in a demo some of them. And I will explain more deeply then. But you, as you can see, yeah, this correlates a lot on what you saw on the last slide with the test. Why we can use this specific tool. So with that, yeah, I directly want to hop over to a demo. As I always say, yeah, looking to it in a demo says more than 1,000 words on a slide. So let's just move on. Share my desktop here, and I hope you can all see it. So, yeah, if we go to the remote connectivity analyzer, this is the first screen that we will see here. So, we see here different tabs, so with different tests that we can run for the different scenarios. The first tab, yeah, shows Exchange Server, and this means I can run several tests against an on-premise Exchange Server. This means an Exchange Server which is yeah, running in the local network of the end user and of the customer. So I can do some checks if the Microsoft Exchange Active Sync connectivity is correctly. I can do some tests for the Exchange Web Services connectivity, Microsoft Office Outlook connectivity test. So if there is auto-discover is working correctly, and I can do some tests on the inbound and outbound mail flow together with POP and IMAP. The same we have here for Link Server and the Office Communication Server. So I can do some remote connectivity test if all the auto-discover is working for Link, and also for the same for Office Communication Server. The most interesting part for us today is the tab on Office 365. Because this will help us to see if the if everything is running correctly for my Office 365 deployment. So if we look here, we have some Office 365 general tests. This means that I can do some checks if the DNS records that I need to set up are correctly configured. The same for the for my link DNS entries, and even if I have a single sign-on deployment, I am able to run some tests if my ADFS server on my on-premises is can be reached correctly. The same for ActiveSync. So am I able to connect with my ActiveSync mobile device to the Office 365 services, the web services, and for example, the Microsoft Outlook connectivity test, auto-discover. So I would like to stop here for a moment and maybe show you, okay, how this test will run at the end. So one of the main top support issues we are seeing within Office 365 is that we are unable to connect to the service when we first set up the clients. So looking at this, I will just open my Outlook. And I'm trying to create a new profile for my received Office 365 subscription. So I'll use my profile name. And the first thing it will ask me for is to put in my email address for which I am I want to connect to. So in this case, I have an Office 365 account with the email address roger@vortex50.com, and I'm just trying to connect to my email mailbox for now. So clicking on next, what happens in the background? My Outlook is trying to find a connection point for my mailbox, which means it's trying to find the connection mail server where I can connect to my mailbox. So this is used by auto-discover DNS entry that we need to configure in our Office 365 environment or with our DNS provider. And as you can see here, for my connection, this is not working. And even if I try to do it without any encryption, it still fails. So I know that there is something wrong. So What I do now is I will go back to the remote connectivity analyzer and start a test to see what might be wrong here. So in this case, we are trying to set up a new profile. So probably there is something wrong with Outlook Auto Discoverer. So this is the one the test that I will select here, and I click on next. So what it will ask me now is to provide me the email address that I'm using for this for my mailbox. I also need to fill out my Microsoft account. In case of Office 365, this is my UPN, so this is the same as my email address. And I type in my password for this test. I must agree on the that the credentials I type in are not used for anything else, and I'm responsible for hosting the test. So just to make sure that we are not using any automated test by hackers, so then we have to give in this specific code. Let me see what that is. Might be T V and L, and I need to verify that. If I'm able to verify, you can see here that I'm able to use this browser session for 30 minutes without having to add the code again. So from that point on, I will start the test, and I will click on perform test. And what it does in the background, it will say, okay, if it can find the auto discover record for my specific mailbox. So yeah, you can see that the connectivity test failed. I wasn't expecting anything else because this is why I set it up. But you can see some additional new details. You can see that the elapsed time for the test running, and you can go deeper into the tests that are have been being done there. So to be able to find the connection point for my mailbox, there are different options for auto discover to be hosted, and these are the different tests that are running. So in this case, you see that all tests are failing, which means that there are probably no auto discover records available for this specific domain, which in my case is correct because I have set it up like this. So this is an easy way to look if the DNS records are available. So the same issue we have with all the other DNS records, and I would like to show you in a bit more detail what kind of records we need for Office 365. So if I log on to the Microsoft Online portal as an administrator, my session timed out because the browser was open for a while already. I log on to the admin portal, and if I just go to domains, you can see I've added the domain to my my tenant in this case. And if I select the vortex50.com, which I was trying to connect to, and show the DNS records, you can see that these are all the records that I need to configure with my DNS provider to be able to use the Office 365 service correctly. And this is also one of the big top support issues that we see. A lot of customers are not able to create these specific DNS records. They are missing some of them. There is maybe a typo within the CNAMEs that needs to be provided. So to be able to check this, there is also another check in the remote connectivity analyzer that you will just go through all the exchange and DNS settings that needs to be configured, or the same for link. So in that case, we can go back to the remote connectivity analyzer and click on start over. This means we will go back to the main page. And let's just say that we are going to look at the Exchange DNS settings. So in this case, I click next again. I have to fill out the domain that I want to check and click on perform test then. And as you can see, in this case, the test is also failing. We see that the test for initial details, there is an entries. There are entries available for this domain. There is an MX record available for this domain, so this is configured correctly. The only thing that is not configured correctly for this domain is the auto-discover CNAME. And as I mentioned before, this is removed by myself to show you how this test gives you the output. So going back to the start screen, you see that we have several different other tests as well. I can only do internet mail tests, test the inbound SMTP email, outbound SMTP email, and also check the POP and IMAC connectivity to Office 365, and even check on the MX record on itself or FreeBSD if I'm using a hybrid environment. So if we look at the other tabs available here in this remote connectivity analyzer, we see also the client. And if we look at this, we have some two tools that can be installed locally on the client machine for the administrator or the end customers. So they are able to do most of the tests available in this web-based interface, but then from a tool installed just on the local machine. So the Microsoft Connectivity Analyzer tool will just help the end client by asking simple questions, wizard-based, to help them to see if they to solve the actual connectivity issue. And the same is for the Link Connectivity Analyzer. So the only thing is that you have to of course take care that if there are any updates on these specific tools, you might need to reinstall these tools to also to get the updated version of the connectivity analyzer. If you use the web-based version, you of course are sure that you always have using the latest version. So what is quite interesting is also the message analyzer tab. And if we look at this, what we can do here is when we can just analyze the header information of a message sent. So for example, your customer is complaining that there's a lot of delays within receiving a message. You should be able to paste the header of an email within this header analyzer and to see what is happening. So maybe we just should have a quick look at this. As you saw, I'm logged in as an administrator in this case. My administrator also has a mailbox. And there are some messages in my mailbox, which I can use to do this analyzing. So I will open just this first message. If it let me. Yeah, there it is. It opens twice. No. And there it is. And on the message, I have some additional actions. And one of the actions is view the message details. And with this, I get the header information of this specific message. And it will show all the hops that has been that this message has been taken and all the timestamps, etc. So if I just copy this out and go back to my header analyzer and just paste it in here and click on analyze headers, you will see that it will give me a more detailed view on the what happens to this message. So you see in a real nice view, what is the submitting host, what is the receiving host, what is the time that the message took from the submitting to the receiving host, and you see the delay here, very nice. So in this case, the delay was 6 seconds between the second hop. You also see some details about the anti-spam report. You, for example, see here the country and region and the language used. This information can be used to more granularly also configure your spam filter in Office 365, because some of the new features that we see in the latest version, latest after the latest update, is that I'm also with Exchange Online Protection able to configure the anti-spam more granularly on country and language. So we, for example, see a spam confidence level of 1. This means that this message is really likely not spam. And we see a lot of other information which can be useful to do some troubleshooting on message flow. So overall, a very nice tool that can be used to troubleshoot Office 365 connectivity issues, which are just one of the top support issues that we see. So with that, I will just hop back to the presentation. I'll just continue here. So the last thing I want to mention on the remote connectivity analyzer is the system requirements. We support every operating system starting from Windows Vista, so Windows 7, Windows 8 after that, and also the server versions starting on Windows Server 2008. The Microsoft.NET Framework 4.5 is required, and this one can be obtained from the Microsoft Download Center. As this is a web-based tool, we of course need to support it in the web browser. So the versions that are supported is Internet Explorer, Google Chrome, together with ClickOnce for Google Chrome, and Firefox together with the Microsoft.NET Framework Assistant for Firefox. One side note here, if I want to use the Link Connectivity Analyzer, which I can install locally on my machine, I have to be aware that it's only supported on the 64-bit version of Windows. Okay, and with that, I would like to show you the Microsoft Online Services Diagnostic and Logging Support Toolkit, in short, the MOSDAL Support Toolkit. So the MOSDAL Support Toolkit is a toolkit that helps administrators to generate logs, which can be used to diagnostic and use diagnostics and troubleshooting on Office 365 configurations. If we go over it in a demo, you can see that we are able to gather network information, installation information, and all service related topics that can be used to determine where a problem that a customer has might be. The output of the MOSDAL toolkit is commonly expected by Microsoft support. So if you are not able to solve a specific issue yourself, Microsoft support most of the time asks if you can run the MOSDAL toolkit on the machine that is having the connectivity issues or other issues, so that you can send the logs to the Microsoft support and they directly can start troubleshooting your issue. In this case, I would really encourage you to take this the step just before opening any support issues to Microsoft, just to make sure that we're not losing any time to ask this information back to you. The download is available on the Microsoft Download Center. The link is pasted in the presentation for your reference. So when should I use it? So if I if I'm facing issues with email and calendaring, if I'm facing issues with instant messaging and online meetings, facing issues with the Office web apps, website and collaboration. So this means if I'm working with SharePoint and I'm having issues there, if I'm having troubles with the activation or uses of a Professional Plus, and also if I'm having issues with the setting up directory synchronization, single sign-on together with the ADFS, and also domain verification. So if I'm setting up my domain, I want to when I want to verify a new domain within Office 365 and the verification is not working, I can also use this tool to get additional information which I can use to troubleshoot the specific issue. And the same for Exchange hybrid environments. So if I'm trying to set up a hybrid environment, Exchange Online connected to Exchange on-premise, and I'm seeing some issues here, I can use this toolkit to generate logs, which might help me to find a solution to the issue. The last four options where I can use it can only be used by the administrator. As you can expect, if I'm setting up directory synchronization as an organization, this is a task that is to be done by an administrator only. So only the administrator probably has a connection to the server where the DirSync is running. So this is only the person that can run this specific test. So as you can see on this slide, there is the Mozilla toolkit has the option to collect a lot of logs from the local machine where the tool is running. We can see system information. We can see the DNS records lookup for link online. I'm just picking some of them. We can have the click to run logs for Office on demand. We can have the logs for the Microsoft Online PowerShell output if we use that for maybe the single sign-on configuration. A lot of logs. There are different scenarios where we can use the Mozilla tool, and not for every scenario we of course need all the logs. So let me just show you in a demo what this exactly means. Using the Mozilla support toolkit, for that we have some prerequisites, and this means that the toolkit must be run on the computer on which the problems occur. This is quite logical, I think, because if we run this toolkit on another PC which don't have the problem, we will not find any issues within the log files. So for some of the tests, some of the scenarios, we may require to enter the Office 365 credentials to perform the diagnostics, because the Mozilla tool will also connect in the background to the Office 365 services and gather information from the service itself as well, together with information from the local machine. Some of the service requirements for Mozilla, we need to run the Mozilla tool on the computer where the application is hosted, and these are mainly the scenarios where I need to be an administrator to be able to troubleshoot it. And if we look at it, it's the directory synchronization, it's single sign-on, it's the domain verification and the Exchange hybrid configuration. So let me show you in a demo how we can use this toolkits and specific for a SharePoint issue that we might have. One click too much. So just sharing my desktop again. And what I will do, I will just open the Mozilla support toolkit. So if you install this support toolkit, this will install first of all the tool, and with that you can also download the mod style training toolkit. And if you look at it, it gives anyone a very good help file on all the scenarios where you can use this this tool for, and how you are where you maybe find some information to troubleshoot the issues that you might have. So I really would encourage you, if you are start using this tool, to also to look in this very detailed help file for your. So looking at the support toolkit, so if we open it, we can see that there are different scenarios listed for us that we can use the tool for. And as you can see, when I just hover over the different scenarios on the right-hand side, you can see a list of all the data that is collected for the specific issues. If I just look at it for a scenario where I have issues with my email and calendar, I need to collect different logs than I am troubleshooting an issue with directory synchronization. So it makes totally sense. So in this case, it just shows you what logs are collected. So for our scenario today, let's have a look at the at the SharePoint issue. So we have one client that's called us, or maybe you. And is reporting an issue where he tries to open the SharePoint team site and wants to upload some of the documents using the Explorer view. And in this case, the Explorer view is not working. So in that case, I will just go in as an administrator and have a look at what the client is, what the client exactly means, to see if I can reproduce this specific issue. So for that, I will just go to the SharePoint site, specifically go to the team site. On the team site, look at the documents that are already there, and try to reproduce the issue of the client. So what the client is doing in this case is tries to open the library with Explorer, and this is a very nice option to easily drag and drop new files to the document library on SharePoint Online. So in this case, the client is clicking on Open Explorer, and I'm getting an error message back that saying that I'm not able to. The very nice thing here in SharePoint Online is that I already get some hints on which tell me what could be the issue. So the first thing is the SharePoint domain name listed in the trusted sites, and if not, please have a look at the knowledge base article that is listed here. So of course, as an administrator, the first thing I do is I will have a look at this knowledge base article. So the knowledge base article explains me how to use the Open with Explorer command and how to troubleshoot issues with this. If I go down, it will tell me, is there any hotfixes installed which needed for this specific feature? What about the authentication? If I logged on to the Office 365, did I check the checkbox to keep me sign in? Did I add the SharePoint site to the trusted sites in the Internet Explorer configuration? And last but not least, also check the web client service. In my case, it happens that I don't have any, that the client that reported the issue is not very knowledgeable on his PC, and I'm not able to do a remote assistant call to help him solve his issue. So in this case, what I ask him is to reproduce the issue. For first, install the Mostel toolkit and try to reproduce the issue and gather the logs for me, so that I, as an administrator for this client, can start troubleshooting it from there. So that's what we're going to do. We go back to the Mostel toolkit, which I asked the client to install. I will check the checkbox websites and collaborations with SharePoint, and I click on next. I'll first get a pop-up from the user account control if I really want to run this tool. And then I'm asked to enter the credentials of the user that is running it. So for my demo, I will just run it in the context of the administrator. But of course, normally you will run this in the context of the of the user having the issue. This one typo. If I don't have this information or I don't want to provide this information, I can also skip this test, which means that some of the diagnostics locking will not happen in the background. We also have the private policy here, so which exactly explains what is happening and what we will do, where the information is used for. So I click up next, and in that case, I will get some steps listed what I need to do. So in this case, I will need to close the application to enable the logging. So just to make sure, I will just close all my Internet Explorer labs. I will restart the application. Connect again to the portal. Go to SharePoint, Team Sites, Documents, and try to open the library in Open with Explorer, reproducing the error message. So after doing that, I will go back to the Mostel toolkit and click on next to start collecting the data for my issue. So what it will do now, it will collect all the data that it has listed for this specific scenario, and this may take some time to finish. So happy enough, I already run this tool this morning just to make sure that we don't have to wait a long time for this demo, and I'm happy to show you what the output is of this at this specific scenario. So we see here the report from this morning, 10:20 here in Germany, and we also see that it directly creates a zip file from my latest report so that I can send it to the Microsoft support. So I think I can troubleshoot this issue myself, so I will just open the reports that have been generated, and we'll just have a quick look on what kind of logs we can see here. So the first thing is the admin applications. So if I'm really running single sign-on for my specific scenario, you will see that there are some ADFS diagnostics which we can see here. So there might be an issue with logging on with the federated domain. In this case, I know that I'm not using the single sign-on, so this is the not the, yeah I don't have to look at this specific scenario. You can see that there are a lot of network tests done. There's even using a network monitor in the background to trace the connection to the online services. I'm doing some NS lookups to see if I can reach the most common DNS entry used for Office 365. You can see that there is a port query to just make sure that all the ports that are need to be open on the local machine to connect to Office 365 are available. So if you suspect that there might be a firewall in between, these log files might give you a clue how you can solve the issue. We also have good system information, so all the information from the local machine, the advanced network diagnostics. We see the name service used. We are pinging the local gateway. We're trying to to see if there are any host files configured. Also the network configuration. So there's an IP config log. There is a log which is called net start to see what all the services are running. So yeah, a lot of logs available which can guide us to what the issue might be on this specific client there. So specific to our scenario, I was not able to open the SharePoint document library with Explorer, and this means that according to the knowledge base article I was directed to, there might be an issue with the trusted sites, and that is the SharePoint is not SharePoint URL is not listed in the trusted sites, or the web client services is not started. So what I'm able to do here is I looked at user applications. I can go to the Internet Explorer, and what it did, the MOS.2, it exported all the registry entities which are related to the Internet Explorer. And specific in this case, I know that the trusted sites is within the registry key of the internet settings, and I can just do a quick search on the domain name I'm using. I think I opened the wrong file. Excuse me. There it is. Oh, interesting. Okay, so in this case, normally there should be the DNS entry of the of my SharePoint site, and just as this is a live demo, let's have a look in our Explorer to the Internet options, security, trusted sites, and see if we have listed the Text50 website. It actually is there, so it seems that I'm just looking at the wrong log file for the moment, or maybe it wasn't available when I did my test this morning. So let me just it is in I was just looking at the wrong log file. So as you can see here, vortex50.sharepoint.com is within the Internet Security Zone Map, so within the trusted sites. But this is not probably not the issue at this client machine, because the site is available within the trusted sites of my Internet Explorer configuration there. So the next thing I need to check is, the article mentioned if the web client service is started. So on the system information, I have the netstart.txt, and this will show me all the services that are running on my machine, on the client machine in this case, of course. And as we look closer, with the W, we see that there is no web client service running. So I did this demo on my own machine, so not on the client machine. So I would ask the client to look at the services and see if he is able to determine if the web client service is running or not. So if you look at my machine where I prepared this demo, you can see that the web client service is on disabled. So I of course did this on purpose to be able to demo this. So what I will do is I will put it back on manually, edit this normally, and we'll start the service. So it's normally just manually triggered if this is used. So to be able to check this, I will need to reload the SharePoint site, and if I try to connect it with Explorer again, You can see that I'm now able to open this SharePoint library with the Explorer view. So with that, I want to jump back to the presentation. So yeah, the only the last thing I would mention on this the Mustel support toolkit is the system requirements. So it's it's compatible with all Windows operating systems starting from Windows XP, SP3 and above. Keep in mind that Windows XP will be out of support starting the 8th of April. So make sure that you update your client machines before that to an higher operating system. Microsoft .NET Framework, the Microsoft .NET Framework 4.0 or a later version is required. This can be downloaded from the Microsoft Download Center. And in addition to the, if we're using the tool for domain verification, DNS setup, and single sign-on, we also require the Windows Azure Active Directory module for Windows PowerShell. So this needs to be in installed as well, so we can run the PowerShell commands if we are collecting the data. So I hope I gave you some insights on the the two tools that I presented, how they can be of help on troubleshooting some of the Office 365 issues that we see. Most issues that we see are related to connectivity, DNS entries, and adding a custom domain to the service. And I think these tools are really helpful to do the first troubleshooting instead of just directly opening a case with Microsoft. So, any questions? Let me check the IM window.
Thanks, Roger. While you're checking the IM window, I'll answer that last question about the slides. We will have the slides available if you go to the community site or the Ignite site. You'll see that within 24 hours, you'll see the slides and a recording of this webcast will be available, so you can grab it there. I'm also going to go ahead and take over as presenter, Roger, if that's okay, and put in some questions, some survey questions we'd like to get your answers on. It always helps us to improve when we can get your feedback.